No, that doesn't make her a hooker. Sorry. She's shy. She's so shy. That's Lily, also, by the way.
Lily!
And, this here is Harmony.
Harmony.
And Carrie May.
Carrie May.
And then Joanne over there.
Joanne.
Wow, you hired the exorcist, that's great.
What is that? Is that like a Yoda thing or what? That's fun, but what?
Oh, no, it's just this thing I do to remember people's names.
Natalie.
Communion After Dark. Happening right now.
body music. The system. Sick of it now. I'm talking to you. Somebody told me. After Dark. It is the week of April 8th. Yeah, it's another week of April. And we have Mouse here with us. Hey, Mouse.
Hi.
Mouse is joining us the week after our 16-year anniversary to continue partying with us for 16 years of Community After Dark. So thank you for coming on.
Thank you.
And excited to have you back. And then, of course, there's Winters and Gold as well, as you can see. And you just heard my set on Paradise again. The last track you heard by me in my set, which was track number 7, if you're counting at home, was Wumpscut. Wumpscut is out of Germany. Wumpscut, of course, is a classic artist who's been around for many years. He has a brand new release out called Schlossgeist. I know Geist means ghost. Not really sure. I really didn't look up what it means completely. Schlossgeist. I don't know. Yeah. That's on Metropolis Records. It's also on his own label, Bates and Koff Media. That is a brand new release of his. There's some new songs on there that have never been put out before. So check that out if you want to hear some new Wumpscut. Wumpscut's put out a bunch of stuff recently. A large amount of it was older stuff that he put out, like extended editions and extra remixes and some stuff. But this is actually the newest material that he's made as of today.
And Schlossgeist means castle ghost.
Castle ghost.
There we go. That's cool.
I knew half of the word. I didn't know
what it happens when you toot at the castle.
Tooting at the castle, you become a ghost. All right, the sixth track in my set was brand new Faderhead, also out of Germany. Faderhead has a his monthly single out, and his new single is called Breathe Again. This is a very awesome sounding synth pop ballad type track. It's not really a ballad, but it's more just very a laid back chill synth pop song. It's a digital single you can pick up, go to his Bandcamp, buy it, give him some love. Faderhead shows his range of vocals on this track, as he does on many of his other songs. He can go many different ways, so you never know what to expect. Good stuff, though. Fifth track in my set is by another band out of Germany called Audio Call. They are a new band on Scanner, a very cool German synth pop band. If you like German synth pop, you'll enjoy this. The song I played was Where Is the Love? It is on their new release called Know Your Murderer. Very dark name for the album. Yeah, pretty cool name, I guess. I don't know. I don't know if murder is a cool name or not.
Yeah, but talk about murder all the time.
Yeah, I've had a change as I get older with kids and stuff. Murder becomes kind of scary now.
But a murder is also
a word.
Group of crows.
I mean, the word.
A murder is also a group of crows.
Oh, and okay.
Today,
well, maybe that's it.
I
maybe
ordered
that's what it is.
A device for me to talk to my crows because I'm that big of a nerd, guys. I have a murder of crows and I want to talk to them, so I ordered a thing.
I don't think they're going to understand you. I have a weird feeling, but. All right, well, there's my first three songs, or the last three songs I played.
And the fourth song that Paradise played is Metamorph out of the US, and this is the song Viridia, and this is the Grindel mix. And that is off Hex, which came out on Distortion Productions.
And the third track we heard was by Antibody from Germany. And the song was called But Can You? Featuring Matt Hart. And that's a digital single you can get on Dark Tunes Music Group.
Yeah, so there's a new Antibody track on Dark Tunes with Matt Hart on there, which is cool. Matt Hart's our buddy out of the UK. Mouse is good buddies with Matt Hart as well. And that new Metamorph is really cool too. There's some other cool mixes on there. Check that album out on Distortion. I think it's one of their newest releases on that label.
It really is. It came out this past week.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. There's a Assemblage 23 mix on there as well, I know for sure. Second track, brand new Rune Conflict out of the U.S., Rune Conflict has a new song called Body Music. This is a dance floor pumping track. Very cool new track by Rune Conflict. You can pick it up on Infactor Recordings, go to Bandcamp and buy it. So, yeah, awesome.
Make you move your body.
Yeah, it's a very cool EBM track there that they put out. I like a large amount. And the first track was by Project Pitchfork out of Germany as well. Their song Summer Walk on their brand new release called Elysium, which is on Tree Soul. This is a fantastic album. If you're a Project Pitchfork fan, they are back with a fantastic new album. I would recommend this one very highly. I wouldn't say their last couple were as good, but this one they've done a great job with, and it's classic Project Pitchfork sound.
Mm-hmm. If you like them, you won't be disappointed. This album.
Very good. Yeah, very good album. So there's my set. All right, and now we're going to do our shot of the week in honor of Mouse joining us for our 16-year. We're only doing one shot, though, this week. We're not doing a multiple like last week. That was just a little too much.
My shot is Largo Bay Apple Spiced Rum. Because I'm still going through all the little bottles I bought for the show.
Okay, so my drink comes out of a mason jar. That I found in the back of my fridge. This was made by Stan Franklin years ago. It hadn't
Holy
been
shit.
Like.
Oh, is that his mead?
4 years ago. Yeah, this is some kind of blackberry mead. And I messaged him and I was like, can I drink this? And he hasn't answered me back. So we'll see.
We'll see if you pat. Yeah,
you can. It doesn't. If it was in the fridge, you're totally fine. Yeah.
If it's honey, if it's honey, it should be good.
Should, yeah.
And it's liquor, but it's in the fridge. It wasn't in the freezer or anything.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm doing the same shot we did last week because I like this one so much, a Jolly Rancher shot, which is watermelon, peach schnapps, and vodka.
Fancy right. little cup thing.
All right. Well, what do you got?
Grand Marnier and Bailey's.
All right. Here we go, right?
Awesome. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Well, drink your drink.
Pete. You know, Sherry, you're not sick anymore now.
No, I know. It tastes like honey and soy sauce.
Oh, no.
That was
oh, God. If you see Sherry fall over, you know why. She just drank something that's been in her fridge for
that
like
was
years
actually,
years.
4 years. That was pretty good. It was like this was like a very strong cinnamon apple cider.
The that shot was. I did was the best. That was a good shot. Those are good shots. If you want to do a watermelon Jolly Rancher at home, those are good shots. Cool. Just watermelon, peach schnapps, peach schnapps, and vodka. It's very
that was
tasty.
My favorite one for the anniversary show was the watermelon Jolly Rancher.
Yeah, it was the best one. Otherwise, you'd have to drink that crap that Mick gave you, or the stuff Lance gave you was really strong, which wasn't bad. It was just really strong.
You know, Mike's been drinking that because there was a bunch laughing at it in the fridge, and he's just been drinking it on ice, like a glass of it every night. I'm like,
what, the
oh
stuff that Lance made?
Yeah, the blue stuff.
Oh, my God. Oh, Jesus Christ, I'm surprised he hasn't fallen over. That stuff's strong. There's a lot of alcohol in that. All right, so Mouse is here. She's going to be coming on with some music. Thank you, Mouse. We're excited to have you back. Yes.
I'm excited to be here.
Thank you. Last week was your special day, which Winter is already advertised. So happy birthday again. I guess it's a special day. Yeah,
I don't celebrate my birthday, and then that way I can pretend that I'm 25.
That you never age?
All the time. And
that
it works.
That would be nice if we never
it
age.
It works. You just tell yourself, guess what? I'm 25 today.
Or you can just celebrate your 25th birthday every year.
All right. And I wanted to also that was really it. Nothing else. There's nothing else really to talk about. I just want to say thank you again to everybody who tuned in to our 16-year anniversary show. If you have not watched it, please go and check it out. Yeah, we record that live together, which we don't do very often. So you can see us on video if you watch us on YouTube, which is the only place we have our video. So if you aren't aware of that yet, we have video on YouTube. Please go watch it. It means a large amount to us. Our YouTube channel, go subscribe if you have not subscribed. And it was a good time last week with the Mad Professor. Lance was here, so it was fun. We had a few other people in the background. Bill Lieb even joined us, which was kind of cool. Came all the way. He stopped his ministry tour. He came and joined us in studio.
And Baby Dice, who isn't a baby anymore.
No, not a baby anymore.
Baby Dice isn't a baby anymore?
Well, I have another Baby Dice, but
you have
Baby Dice 2.
You have Baby Toddler.
What is it that you said, Tom? You said
Toddler Dice.
You said Mama Dice, Baby Dice, and
a Triple Dice.
Triple Dice.
Triple Dice. There you go. All right. Gold's coming up with next with music, so come back for that.
This is Communion After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Gold.
Sequoia. To our end. It is happening everywhere. A slow and fast funeral march for ourselves. We are mere remnants of what we once were. And we will disappear like we lived, in violence and death. So dance to the sound of extermination. Dance to the sound of human expiration. Dance! Dance! Exequil! Execution.
welcome back to Communion After Dark. I'm DJ Tom, and you just heard New Leather Strip from Denmark doing a cover of the Eurythmics' Here Comes the Rain Again from their long line of appreciation albums, and this is Appreciation 7. You can pre-order that on Cleopatra Records.
That's cool. I haven't heard that one. I'll have to check that out.
So are these all new tracks?
Yeah, they're all covers.
Are they like collected covers? Because he's always been doing covers.
No, I think there's maybe like one. I think there might be one on there. I think there's a B-movie one that he already did, Nowhere Girl. But it's all pretty fresh.
It's fresh. Fresh. All right. Yeah, hey, wasn't there a long time ago there was a really cool Here Comes the Rain Again cover that was done by Minerve, right?
And Minerve did that, yeah.
Yeah, that was a great cover.
Minerve. I haven't heard of Minerve.
My nerve.
Wait, no, not Merch. Not Merch, no.
Minerve.
Did. Yeah. What was Minerve's song?
You're getting on my Minerve.
Oh, they had a bunch of stuff.
All right, what's
that was good. That was good, Dad. Dad jokes.
The sixth track you heard was by a band called Contaminated Intelligence from the U.S., and the song was called Unforeseen, and that's performed by Estetish. And that's the Unforeseen EP you can get on Bandcamp. And then prior to that, you heard Tension Control from Germany with a song called Der Sheriff. It's not the DAF cover, it's something fresh. And that's a digital single you can get on Bandcamp.
And the fourth song in Tom's set is Logic and Olivia out of Germany. And this is the song Enemy, and this is the dance mix that came out on Channel 2, Part 2 on Infected Recordings. It's in pop.
And the third track in Gold Set is by Xanias. We love her out of Germany. She's going to be at Absolution Fest.
Yeah, right here.
Mm-hmm. All super right. So that was the song Dune Skipper. And it is off of her album, Ecdysis. I'm sure that's some complicated medical term that I don't know. Because a lot of her songs have, like, medical terms. But anyway, it's on Metropolis Records, and you can pick it up on Bandcamp.
So Dune Skipper just makes me think of, like, in Dune, the way they have to do the little doot-doot-doot. And then hop sideways when they're going down a dune to the worm.
Oh, the sand walk.
Yeah, they do the sand, the dune walk. That's what it makes me think.
Out of rhythm.
They're dune skippers.
Out of rhythm.
Second track you heard was by Neuroclast and Grab Your Face from Germany and France, respectively. The song called Exquail. From their Hybrid Black Tracks 3 compilation. You can get it on Hybrid Black Records.
Is that Morris Black's label or something?
Yeah, I think he's associated with it.
Oh, okay.
We started off with Brand New Street Fever in the U.S. I think they're from Boise, Idaho, I think. And the song was called Trust from their long-awaited full release album called Absolution out on Bandcamp.
What?
Absolution. No, it's cool. This is a great album.
What is going on with Absolution? There's a lot of Absolution stuff happening here.
I know. It's on your shirt. It's
on
like
my
everywhere.
Shirt. It's on. He played a song off of Absolution. That's pretty cool. And yeah, by the way, we did announce Absolution, which is a, now I guess you could say it's an annual event that we've done now. This will be the fifth year for Absolution. So this will be our 5-year anniversary. And I'm very excited about it. Looking forward to it. We played a few bands already on this show that will be at Absolution, Rune Conflict, Xanias. That was not really by design that we played those bands, but they will be at Absolution. So, yes, I'm very excited. B-Born Baton will be at Absolution, which is just amazing.
Oh, my gosh. I am so excited for that.
Ultrasun.
And Ultrasun.
Ultrasun is going to be the thing for me.
Yeah.
Some great bands playing Absolution. Checked out. Tickets are on sale. So go buy them before they're all gone. And yeah, come to Tampa and hang out with some of
your
friends.
With all of us.
Hang out with all of us.
Yes.
And all three nights are at Crowbar. I love Crowbar because it's a perfect size to have a very intimate experience watching bands. So.
Yeah, it's a good festival. It's a good time. Good event, anyways. I don't know about festival, but it's an event. Good event. I hope you will join us.
It's a festival because it's 3 days of walking around. Yeah.
Sure. If you want to, whatever you want to call it, call it. But all right, Mouse, you're coming up next.
Yes, I am. And I'm going to start out with New Nightclub.
This is Communion After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Mouse.
Mix the pleasure with the pain. Lick the honey to the stains. Get you high on everything. Careful what she brings. Cause pretty girls do ugly things.
Thank you. gleich bei den Nachbarn.
Ding dong.
Kurz guten Tag sagen.
Hallo.
Und dann wieder gehen.
Bis morgen, ne?
So als wäre nichts gewesen.
Ich schwör dir, keiner merkt was.
Leben am Limit.
Und auf diesem Meme in der Timeline.
Bei Facebook.
Steht geschrieben, so geht es nicht weiter.
Du bist gemeint, Digga.
Du bist die Revolution.
Ja.
Crash deine Reputation. Komm schon, tu es.
Und
like diesen Beitrag.
Leben am Limit.
Lass es raus, ja.
Ja.
Verschieb den Papierkram. Wie ein Outlaw. Von Montag auf Dienstag. Ja, genau so. Ich seh schon den Grabstein. Hier ruht ein Staatsfeind.
Leben am Limit.
Mega krass.
Leben am Limit.
Mega krass.
Insatiable.
we'll just end up alone.
Black Abyss. just live.
Welcome back to Communion After Dark. I am Mouse, and I am back as a guest. And I got to play a bunch of stuff that I've been listening to that I love a lot. And I hope that you enjoyed it. So the last track was Beyond Border out of Germany. And this is their song Let's Just Live, which I love so much. But now there's a DMX remix. Not like DMX, the rapping guy. I don't think it's that guy. But it's a single that you can get on No Cut. You have to go to Apple to get this. It is not on their Bandcamp. I don't know why. But it came up on my Spotify, and I had to go search for it.
Nice.
And the sixth track in my set is by Matt Hart out of the UK. And this is the song Black Abyss, which he has put out on a Black Abyss EP with a couple of remixes. I played the Opal Dusk remix, which is actually my favorite. But if you get a chance, go listen to the Technovore remix, which is just, it just kicks ass. But this one was a little bit more groovy.
And Matt Hart is actually going to be in the United States later this year. I believe it's going to be around June, late June, early July. He'll be playing some shows in the United States. Woo!
Oh, I hope I catch him.
Yeah, we should catch Matt. That'll be great. I'm glad he's coming over. I hope anybody who can see him goes to see him for sure.
Yeah. And then the fifth track in my set was by Dancing Plague. His new album is out, Elogium. You guys have been playing a lot of tracks from it. I don't think you played this track, Cold Fire.
Nope.
It's further down on the album. So I love this track so much. It is on Avant Records.
We just got a chance to meet him.
We got a chance to meet Connor. And my favorite track is the title track of that album. And just watching or being just, it was crazy to finally see Dancing Plague and like those vocals coming out of his mouth, because he's such a kind of shy little person. And then those vocals coming out of his mouth was just amazing. So.
Yeah.
Yay. And the fourth song in Mouse's set is Run Level Zero out of Sweden. And this is the song Manifest. It's a single that is self-released, and it's amazing.
It is amazing.
It sounds really good.
It kind of sounds like Absurd Minds Project Pitchfork a little bit, the vocals.
Nice. Yeah.
Really good. Really good.
Nice find. I love Run Level Zero. I didn't even know they were still making music.
He's got a band camp, and he hasn't put out anything in 2 years.
Isn't it crazy? Because then I got this email. I'm like, Run Level Zero? Really? New release? Yeah. And I thought it was great stuff. It's really great stuff.
I hope there's an album soon.
Mm-hmm. Gold, did you know about this one?
Yeah, because they're playing Berlin in September.
Okay, so you knew about it because of that?
Yeah, they knew they had new stuff coming out.
Oh, okay.
He was talking about it online a little bit. But yeah, it's cool.
Nice. Right.
Tom, you want to read the third one?
Yep. We heard Mobius from the U.S. with a song called Misbehave For Me. And that's a self-titled single from their self-release on Bandcamp.
This band is so hot. Yep. They are so hot right now. So they are putting out a single all the time. It's probably every month or maybe every 2 weeks or something like that.
And that's okay.
And every song is fire. It's like fetishy. I don't know what this is called. Dancy, industrial, mid-tempo kind of.
Yeah, industrial bass.
Industrial bass, maybe. Yeah. But it's groovy stuff, and I love it.
It's really well produced too.
The second track in my set was by Grostatgefluster.
What?
Grostatgefluster. Wow, perfectly pronounced, right?
Yeah, they're the band. I can't remember the name of their song. They had some crazy ass song. But anyway, they're amazing. Out of Germany. A lot of fun. This song is called Leben am Limit. And this is from their album Das Über Ich. and it's self-released.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm impressed. Mouse is finding some cool shit. Yes. I didn't know they had new stuff out.
And I love this track. It's just, they have a whole album. And, you know, they're ridiculous. And we love any band that's ridiculous. So I hope you like that.
They had that one song, remember? What the fuck?
I don't remember it.
Yeah, we used to get play at the castle like all the time.
I can't.
That was when they had the go-go
dancers. Tom, do you remember
the
Gostadga Fluster song? I don't know. But anyway, Tom, they have a hit that's out there that
I remember.
We haven't thought about in like 10 years, but it's great stuff. Okay, yeah. And then I started out with Nightclub. Oh. So Nightclub is the other hot band. Get on top of this album, oh my god. So they're out of the US, and every track they put out is just catchy. It's like industrial pop, goth pop, I don't know.
Yeah, I call it goth pop, and this is my favorite album.
Goth pop, let's call it
by
goth
far.
Pop.
It's super poppy.
They're
dark.
So hot that you would like burn if you went near them.
So the song was called Pretty Girls Do Ugly Things, and this is off of their album Masochist, and you can get it on Cadillac Insomniac. That's what it says on their Bandcamp, and I provided the Bandcamp link so you can get it there.
They're one of those bands that just took off. I don't know. What scene they fit into necessarily, but they're popular in a lot of different areas, and aren't they on a big tour? Yeah, they're on a huge tour right now around the United States with Rose Garden Funeral Party and
yes, that's right.
Somebody else, I don't remember who else is with them. Maybe Backstreet Boys? No, Backstreet Boys.
Are they coming to Florida?
Backstreet Boys?
Are they coming to Florida?
Oh, Nightclub. No, Nightclub's not coming to Florida. No, they're not. No, they skip Florida.
I might drive to Atlanta.
Which is typical, yeah.
But they're hitting Atlanta.
Oh, I'm sure they are. I don't, because it's a huge tour. It's around most of the United States. Florida, a large amount of time doesn't get included in the United States for some reason. I don't really know why.
We're like that little extra piece of skin on the United States.
Yeah, exactly. They're
like that dangly piece of skin.
Cut it off. We're not including Florida. Florida is not part of the United States, so there's a large amount of bands that do that. But yeah, they are touring though, and like you said, they're coming up through Atlanta and going back up East Coast. I don't really know what their dates are, so I mean, you have to check that out. I mean, who knows? They might have already even possibly played this area, but I don't think they have. I think they started off on the West Coast and they're heading this way. But it's a huge tour. It's a very long tour, so they're going to be out there for a while. So yeah, check them out as long as you don't live in Florida, as we just mentioned. But yeah, there you go. Some new stuff. Cool, Miles. Yeah. Thank you for all that awesome stuff you picked out. It's cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I hope you guys enjoyed the set. I tried so hard to find songs that weren't already played on the show. And I'm going to go back and listen to that Beyond Border again, because that stuff is awesome. Everything they do is great.
They are great. Yeah, we love Beyond Border.
Are you sure they're not from Sweden? Are we sure they're not from Sweden?
I know, really. You would think they were with the way they do their music, but no, they're German.
Very emotional, melodic.
Yes. Excellent band. And their new album, Gathering, is fantastic, so go pick that up. All right, so there's Mouse's set. Winter is going to be finishing off our show here in the near future with another track. Thank you again to everybody who has been listening to our show. Remember, it goes up every single Monday. If you want to check us out, we're on Mixcloud still. And if you can recommend us to your friends and family, please do. But thank you again. We received so many nice messages for our 16-year anniversary.
Oh,
so many people asking us to make sure we keep the show going and thanking us for what we've done over the years and how much it means to them. And so, yeah, that's really very kind of you all. We appreciate it. Obviously, we can't do this forever, but it means a large amount. So, yeah, spread the word about our show, and hopefully we will still be around for a little bit longer to enjoy it with you as well. But let's go to Winter Set so we can hear more music.
This is Communion After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Winters.
take flight. The hearts of those who dare, the flames of freedom still flare.
Raise our voice, breaking free from silence's torture.
right. Welcome back to Community After Dark. This is Winters. You just heard my thoughts. And that last track you heard is Mortis. That's the song Blood. And this is a single that came out on Dark Tunes Music Group. This is a very gothic project that is on Dark Tunes.
Not to be confused with Mortis.
Right. I was going to say that, right. Not to be confused with the guy.
It sounds the same.
The guy who dresses like an elf. Or not an elf. What do they call those? Trolls? Was it a troll?
A troll.
That's right.
He would be insulted if you said it was an elf.
Elf.
And the fifth song in my set is brand new. It's In Light. I think it stands for Nightlight. I'm not sure. He's out of France. And this is Shadows Cast, which is on the upcoming album Lux and Tenebris that comes out on April 16th. And that is self-release.
All right.
You know, every time you play a new band, it looks like you spelled it wrong, but that's actually how it's spelled. It's N-L-I-G-H-T.
Is this a new band by M. Night Shyamalan?
Yeah, this is his dark wave band.
And he's super sweet. So, like, if I've ever, like, if I pre-ordered this album, and he'll send me a private message. It's not even through. He sends me a separate message. Thank you so much for your support and blah, blah, blah. Like, he still has time to do that, even though he's, like, gaining a lot more popularity now. And that's really good. Dark wave, cold wave, dark.
Our track in Winter set was by Love at Arax.
It's Lavatarax.
Lavatarax.
I was saying Lavatarax.
Lavatarax.
Lavatarax. All right. They're out of France.
Lavatarax. See, me and Mike say this. Lavatarax.
But this is another band that's going to be at Absolution, which is fantastic. And yeah, looking forward to having them. They're coming all the way from France to play for you. And this is a new track that Winter's played by them called Earl Condition, which is off their upcoming release called Sophomore, or is it out already?
No, it came out this past Friday, guys.
Oh, sorry.
Brand new.
Sorry. It's a brand new release called Sophomore, and that is on Cold Transmission Music. So, fantastic. I'm looking forward to meeting this band. Very excited to have them at Absolution. They will be playing on Saturday with B-Barn Baton, Male Tears, and many other great bands. So, yeah, looking forward to that. This should be fun.
I know. They came a couple months ago. And yes, they went to Miami and Orlando, and me and my husband were super upset that we missed it because it was like during the week. There was no way for us to go. So I'm super excited that they were added to Absolution.
Okay, the third song in Winter's set was by Enzo Kraft. They're out of Belgium, and this was their song Chains of Silence, which is a single, and you can get it on Enzo Kraft Music. Or Wool E Discs.
That's the last label that Enzo was on. Enzo was like, when I used to do the Winters, I'm a huge fan of him. And the second song in my set is by Analytica out of Canada. And this is the song Barricades that is on the brand new album Strategy of Tension. It came out on Suction Records. Really good minimal wave synth pop. This one is more of an 80s synth pop feel. It's got that 80s synth to it, and it's just, you're going to get addicted to that song like me. It's catchy. One of those songs that gets stuck in your brain.
Earworms.
Yeah, it's an earworm. And then I started everything off with brand new Dead Astronauts. This is the song Void on their upcoming album Ghost. And this is just a track that they dropped. It comes out at the end of this month on Cold Transmission Music, but you can pre-order now and they'll alert you whenever they drop a new track on it for you to go get, like I got this past Friday. And that was my set. And you got a last song coming up that is kind of funny.
Kind of funny. We're going to do donations for the week. Again, thank you everybody who's been donating and still is our monthly donators to our podcast. We appreciate you all very much. And, you know, especially through all these years, 16 years now, it's been crazy. So if you want to be a monthly donor, which we would love. All you have to do is go to communionafterdark.com and click the donate button, and then hit the little box, check the box, and you can become a monthly donor to our podcast, and we would love you for that. Monthly donors this week were from Dominic Witzak, Luis Garcia Rivera, David Kreshmer. Yep, David Kreshmer, I apologize. I said that, and then I lost my train of thought. Marcus Kunenstein, Rupert Oswald, Tobias Sargent, David Munoz, Will Fries, Alan Huddleston, Oliver Revit, Iron Wallach, Seven Snort, who we know out of Tampa, John Dillinger, Shelly Wiley out of Ravens and Rockers. Thank you so much, Shelly, for continuing to support us for so many years. Man, it's been a long time. Thank you so much. Go check out Ravens and Rockers, by the way. Jan Nicholas Erith, Ben B, Catherine Bowles, Jill P, Sven Volsten, Joseph Fair, Daniel Weiss, Neil McCombi, Daniel Sauerwine, Eleanor Duvivier, Roland P, David Klingholz, Alice Luna, and I believe that covers everybody that donated. Yes, looks like that covers everybody for this week.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Yes, thank you. I'm sorry. I was just trying to make sure we got... Oh, no, we missed one. I apologize. And I'm sorry. We got one from Marie Kiefer, who's from Wisconsin. Thank you so much, Marie. Marie has been donating to our show for a long time, and it means a large amount. And yes, you're fantastic, Marie. Thank you so much. And Ben B as well. Another Ben B. So we got a couple of Ben B's on this show. We got Ben Bullcock and then another Ben B. So they're different people, I believe, though. Or maybe they're not. Who knows? And we did get one-time donation this week from Winston. I'm sorry. I don't want to screw up your last name, Winston. Let's just go with Winston P. He is out of Denver, Colorado. Thank you so much, Winston, for donating to the show. And I'm trying to see if Winston left us a message. No. So now, if you do send us a one-time donation, you leave us a message, we will read it on the show. But yeah, no message from Winston. So thank you, Winston, for donating, and thank you for listening to us in Denver, Colorado. We appreciate you. All right, Winters, what's your last track?
And so my last track came out on Ombra International, which is a label I follow that does a lot of Italo disco and dark Italo. And this is Carassimian, which is out of France, which is a like Italo EBM techno, if you want to call it that, but not really, dark electronic project. And this is the song SDFXN, which could be Satisfaction. And they say that this is an original. It's not a cover. Or the way that it's written up is they made it their own rework, if you will. But I just put it in here. It's a nod to Benny Benassi.
Come back for comments.
Yeah.
welcome back. That was the not Benny Benassi song, but nod to Benny Benassi. And we're going to read comments.
Okay, comments. I'm reading this because Paradise doesn't want to read it. So we got some comments from PresSama7592, who says, congratulations, Communion. 16 years. Mad Professor stuff was crazy. That's all one sentence, by the way. Mm. And then, what did Mad Professor do?
All over the place.
Hell.
It's all over the place. It started out with Revolting Cocks.
He did a good job, though. Yeah, it was a very eclectic set he played last week. It was good job.
Good job. And then from Al Risden, who says, your music has carried me through countless miles at night while photographing the stars and avoiding the night creatures who are also listening in.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's a great comment.
Love that comment.
I love great comments. And then we got one from Deathbed Question, who says, oh man, I feel personally attacked. I want to spin Man in the Box by Alex Braun if I ever DJ again. Me to a T.
Interesting. I need to listen to lyrics again on that one because I don't really know exactly what he's talking about, but I need to listen to the lyrics.
And then we got one from the Cyber Salvager, who says, congratulations on your anniversary from Oxfordshire in England. Here's hoping we'll all be around for the next 16 years.
Yeah. That's pretty awesome.
And then we got one from FrogBase12. Congratulations, CAD team. I've been a fan for 13 years now. Looking forward to more years. Thank you. And then we got another one. Last one. I'm going to read. The last one I'm going to read is from Rick Newman. Mr. Teapot, or what is his name now?
Who knows? Just go with Rick. He's a Dolphins fan.
Rick
the Dolphins fan.
Ah, the absolute chaos of the group shot. Chaos is exactly the word.
That's right.
And then we ran a little bit over, so I'm just going to read a couple of these. Thank you, everyone, for the amazing comments. Jenna Snell said, congratulations. Looking forward to seeing you all every week. I love CAD so much. Oftentimes, I feel like your show saves my life. I know how that may sound. My favorite discovery this week has to be DJ Gold, this time accessory, Dark Dance of Life, the Vampires Club remix. Cheers. And then KMJ36 said, another fantastic show as always. Listening for the third time since Monday. Happy sweet 16th. Me After Dark, Christina Marie. That's our friend in Tampa that supports a lot of the live shows.
I met her.
And then David Muno said, woohoo, happy 16-year anniversary. Kat is now old enough to legally drive, so time to hit the road with some awesome tunes. But what happened to the black lipstick and eyeliner as promised? I'd list out all the great songs this week, but half of what was played was absolutely killer. I'm glad you guys have been putting in the work for 16 years, and hopefully life conspires to keep you all in the CAD game for many years to come, putting smiles on listeners' faces on a weekly basis. Much love, guys. And then I'm going to read one more.
David.
And this is from Vanna Carag from Mexico. Mexico, I congratulate you for the great project you have carried out during all these years of great music, and I wish you many more years to come. Thank you for all the great music you share with us. And that's really all we have time for. I put a bunch more in there, but we kind of ran a little bit long. So thank you, everybody, for the amazing comments. I'm sorry for all the ones we didn't read.
Yeah, thank you so much for the support and for the love. I mean, it's been a long journey, so we appreciate you all. Yeah, it's been fun. I mean, regardless of what's happened in between, it's been a good time. Who would have ever expected 16 years ago that this show would have ever turned into anything? Honestly, nobody. And
you need to find like a listener who had a baby mm-hmm. when the show started. That's
right.
It's old now.
Right.
There has who to had be a somebody baby out there? I don't know. There's has somebody. To have been a listener who had a baby around. Cat baby.
Yeah, cat baby. That'd be funny. But yeah, no, nobody ever thought of anything. Trust me, when this show started, somebody asked that. Trust me, when this show started, the last thing ever on anybody's mind is that would be popular. Nah, never crossed anybody's mind. In fact, when me and Griffin first started it and then Gold was brought in, I mean, we just did it for fun. There was no other reason. It was just something to do. And it was something to do before we went out to the castle and get music out to people. But I mean, the honest truth is that we probably thought there'd be like about 30 people listening. So, I mean, hey, we exceeded our expectations. So, I mean, we can always say that and look back on that. It's easy in life to look back, and I mean, not look back on where things started and just like you get lost in your current situation. But it's pretty amazing when you really look back at where this all started with a little penis microphone that was absolutely worthless. And yeah,
and somebody did comment asking if there's early photos of, I have a couple photos,
there is some.
Of the dining room.
Yeah, there's some. They're still
the
on our
on the website, right? Somewhere.
There's still some on the website from Mouse and
yeah.
Griffin.
You guys
and
should
all,
have
yeah.
it on. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, they're there. There's still some on our website, communiafterdark.com. We didn't get rid of them. Mm-hmm. I don't know. They're not from the beginning, but I mean, they're early enough. So, yeah. But anyways, all right, we're done for this week. And we will, I guess, see you all next week then. Thank you so much for listening.
For coming back.
Thank you.
And thanks, bye, Miles. Everybody. Have an amazing week.
See ya.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah. Is Tom gone?
Well, I heard noise was coming out of the thing, so he's probably there.
Yeah, they can't see him.
Mel, is there any word from Tom?
I don't know. Tom's gone.
No, I know he's gone, but I mean, have you...
Tom, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay, we
can't
see
you.
It just says Tom.
What's the thing you guys were talking about online? You and Gold Mouse, you guys want to talk about that with First Contact or something?
Happy First Contact Day!
It's Star Trek Day.
Well, yeah, but I mean, by the time the show airs, it's not Happy Contact.
Well, that's all right. Just explain it. It's fine.
Yeah,
so what does it mean, Tom?
Well, in...
What day did it fall on? I mean, so people know at least.
2063.
April 5th, 2063, first contact with the Vulcans.
Yeah, that's when the Vulcans land after World War III.
And so it had something to do with us now or no?
Yeah. Not yet.
No,
not
that
yet.
Happens.
It's in the future.
That's the first time when aliens land on the planet.
It's Star Trek lore.
It was the first contact movie at the end. That's what they're.
Yeah.
Zephyr and Cochrane.
Oh, the movie with Jodie Foster?
No, Zephyr and Cochrane did the first warp flight. And then the Borg was trying to stop it, but then Captain McCard and everybody like made sure it happened.
Oh, he's not.
So cut that out. Cut it.
Cut that out.
Will someone turn off that music?
That's enough. I'm putting an end to this freak show right now.